has produced multiple shows for television and the web, and has worked on air as a reporter, anchor, and a producer at TV news affiliates in Arizona, Wisconsin, and Missouri. In addition to her work, she loves kids, fantasy football. How do you have time for that?
Superheroes don't sleep, right?
Superheroes never sleep. That's right. Hanging, that's the bag under our eyes. Hanging with friends and fam, salsa dancing, hiking, traveling, her cat Bella, and being an aspiring yogi.
Yoga, right?
Yoga, I know. Liz did that on purpose, so I made a fool of myself. Anyway, welcome. Welcome our guest speaker, superhero Lauren.
Good morning. Is everybody awake? Okay, fantastic. As she mentioned, my name is Lauren Burgoyne, and I'm the founder of the Greater Purpose Project School Superheroes Tour, and I have to tell you, ooh, is that me? Am I ringing? I'm so loud. I'm sorry for that. I have to tell you, I am pumped to be kicking off our school year here with you guys today. So, since we're going to be talking a little bit about how to inspire a superhero campus at each one of the Gilbert Public Schools, I want to make sure that you guys are in a superhero mindset, okay? You with me? I need you to channel your inner Spider-Man, Superman, the Incredible Hulk. All right, wait a minute, maybe not the Incredible Hulk. I don't want anybody turning green and knocking over tables, okay? But you get the picture. I'm gonna need everybody to raise a superhero arm. Can you guys flex? Everybody wearing a superhero deodorant? Okay, fantastic. And I'm gonna ask you, are you ready for GPS being at Superhero Saturday? So I'm gonna ask you again, are you ready for being at Superhero Saturday? Fantastic! Okay guys, thank you so much. So now that I know that you're with me here, all the superheroes are in this room, I need you to take a second, a couple seconds, we're gonna meditate on something. Close your eyes if you can. If you've had too much caffeine like me, you don't have to, but I want you to think on the word superhero. And I want you to think about the image that comes to your mind. Is it a man? Is it a woman? Do they have rippling muscles and a statuesque physique? What are their superpowers? Can they leap buildings with a single bound? Can they fly? Are they shooting spiderwebs out of their fingernails? Now I want you guys to open your eyes. Today we're gonna give Batman a break, okay? We're gonna introduce a new league of superheroes. You're not going to find them in a comic book or in a multi-million dollar movie set. You're not going to find them on a lunchbox or on your kids' pajamas. But these superheroes, their powers to overcome adversity, be kind to others, and to really make a difference in the world, their superpowers are even more extraordinary. Because they are your children. They are superheroes. And the people backing these superheroes are all of you. I know most of you probably didn't get a ton of sleep last night. You're here on your Saturday because of your kids. And so for all of that, I want to give everybody here a round of applause. I don't need my notes. I speak by heart today. Now I want to tell you guys, for our program, when we go into the schools, we're inspiring kids to discover their inner superhero. We're exploring how they can use their unique talents and differences to inspire others in a very high energy, wave your hands in the air kind of program. And each superhero has a sidekick. This year I'm pumped to announce that we have Lindsay Fry. She's an Olympic U.S. women's hockey player, a silver medalist, and I think she likes to think I'm the Robin to her Batman, but it's all good. Lindsay's coming with me this year to inspire the students. And one of the first things that we do is we introduce the students to superhero youth. So a superhero youth might be a boy like Dylan Siegel. Dylan is 8 years old, and he loves chocolate and his best friend Jonah. Dylan is a very healthy little guy, but his best friend Jonah is sick with a very rare liver disease. So when Dylan was 6 years old, he said, "Mom, Dad, I want to do something to help my best friend." And his superpower is creative writing. So he said, "I want to write a book." So Dylan, at 6 years old, wrote a book called Chocolate Bar the Book. The premise of this book is to use the word chocolate bar in the place of awesome. So for example, I would say, the V-neck superhero parents this morning are so chocolate bar. You get it? Okay, you with me? So this book, fast forward a couple years, is now being read in every state across the US. It's being read in dozens of countries, and it has raised more than $1 million. And each penny that comes in because of this book is going directly to the University of Florida medical team where they are trying to cure this young boy's disease. So these are the kind of stories, these are the kinds of things that your students are capable of. I brought a prop with me. All superheroes like their props, right? It can start at home today with something as simple as this jar that I picked up here. This is a GPP superhero jar. So what you do is you have your superhero jar and you have a list of superhero feats next to it. Whatever your family thinks is a superhero power, it could be something like baking brownies for an elderly neighbor or being extra kind to your brother or sister, volunteering your time at the Humane Society. And every time your superhero kid does something really positive, you put a penny in their jar, a nickel, a dime, a dollar, whatever you're able to. And at the end of the month, the goal is to have $1. I know it sounds, you know, what can a dollar buy? But if you had all of the parents from each of your kids' classes, let's say maybe $25 to $30 a month, that could sponsor a kid in another country for the entire year if they were to bring a dollar in every month. It could afford them school supplies, food, all by your superhero strengths, which start at home. And maybe you want to do it a little bit closer to home. Maybe that $30 is spent on a care package to a veteran, or for an adopt-a-family program, or for your local Humane Society. I can tell you, I know this, your kids are going to come up with the most creative projects. So much more astounding than I believe that we can come up with today. But I believe it is our job as the older superheroes is to guide them, is to lead them, because they want to help. They want to show their purpose. They want to show their kindness. And it is our responsibility to give them that opportunity. Now, while I don't know what your superhero kids are going to come up with, I can tell you that I know it's going to be more extraordinary than any of us can imagine. So I'm going to be here all day at my booth. We're going to be doing a little superhero photo shoot with all of you guys and some superhero props. We're going to have more information and a superhero starter kit, including a superhero costume for your little superheroes at home to get them inspired. But again, I want to thank you guys so much on behalf of the Greater Purpose Project Superheroes Tour, and let's go get it done!
Raffle ticket filled out yet? You just